Hey, hello everyone, hope you are doing well. In this video, we will discuss another model of credit risk management, that is modern portfolio theory. Let's look into this theory. So this theory is also known as Harry Markowitz theory. So this theory was developed by this man whose name is Harry Markowitz. So he is an American economist. He was born on August 24, 1927, and he is still alive. His best known work is this theory which we are going to discuss, that is modern portfolio theory. So he also got Nobel Prize in the year 1992 for his work in the economics. So what is this modern portfolio theory? So for understanding what is this modern portfolio theory, we must understand the meaning of this word portfolio. Portfolio means range of investments. So you will clearly understand this by the next slide. So first look at what are the terms this theory is aiming at. So first, this theory focuses on diversification. I told you portfolio here means the range of investments. So this theory, it is mainly focusing on diversification, risk and return, and negative correlation between the stocks. So let's discuss the first point, that is diversification. So look here, there are two images. One image is, it is telling us to invest in the different baskets. So here, investing in different basket means investing in the different investment opportunities. Suppose this basket is investment in the shares. Suppose this basket is investing in some products. Suppose this basket is investing in like fixed deposit or investing in the saving accounts, etc. So diversification means the amount you have, you should not invest in one particular investment. Like here, don't put all eggs in one basket. So if you are putting all the eggs in one basket, there is the chances of breaking of those eggs. Similarly, if we invest all our money in one investment, there is high risk. That is very risky. Why? Because on the time of getting returns, if that particular, suppose you have invested in the shares, and suppose if the company share value decreases in the future, your all the money, all the earnings of your life will be in the risky position. So all the money you have, whatever the money you have, better to invest that money into the different investment opportunities other than investing in one area of investments. That is, invest in the different baskets. Don't put all the eggs in one basket. That means invest in different areas other than investing in one particular area of investment. Next concept this theory aiming is risk and return. So for choosing where to invest, the answer is we must ascertain the return and the risk. So we have already discussed the risk return trade-off. So higher the risk, higher the return. Lower the risk, lower the return. But higher risk will not always promise you the good returns. It is not guaranteeing you, or it is not promising you that if you have high risk, high returns we will give. It is not guaranteeing you. It is just an assumption. So here, return and risk. By knowing the return and the risk, we can choose the investment. So, knowing the percentage of return on investment I'm giving, and accordingly what percentage of risk that investment is posing. So, by calculating the return and the risk, we can choose one investment. Next point it is focusing, that is negative correlation between the stocks. Suppose your money, whatever the money you have invested in shares. Suppose you had 1 lakh of money, 1 lakh rupees you have, and you are investing into two investment options. One is shares and another you are investing in some products. So as we know, shares are risky. Its value goes on fluctuating. So here, on the time of getting returns, this shares, you have divided your 1 lakh rupees into 50,000. Here you have invested 50,000, here you have invested. So that company's share value suddenly decreases. So you are now in a risky position and you are facing loss. But on the other hand, the other area of investment, that is investing in the products, you are getting a very good return here. So what this theory is telling you, that invest in the opportunities, invest in the stocks which are negatively correlated. If one stock is giving loss, means you should invest in such a stock where you can get profit. That is, one investment can offset the other investment. If you are facing loss in one investment, means on the other hand you can expect profit from your other investment. So this is shares. Investing in the shares, you are in the risky position, but simultaneously you choose another investment where you are getting profit. Chances of getting profit is good, means it is negatively correlated. These two are going in the opposite direction. This one is rising and this one is falling. So this is negatively correlated. How much degree of correlation, negative correlation is high, that much is safe for the investor. Because if you invest in the opportunities who are going in the same direction, like you have invested in both two companies, that is in shares only. So if they are going in the same direction, means it is decreasing, and one company's shares is also decreasing, means that is risky for you. On the other hand, in the products also, if that investment, two companies product you are investing, one company is also showing loss, another company is also showing loss, means that is not good for you. Always have to invest in the products which are negatively correlated. So here, for making you understand properly, assume that I have 40,000 of 4 lakh rupees. So I decided, I have two options. One is depositing in the bank and another is investing in the stocks. So first option, let's look into the first option. I'm simply depositing this 4 lakh rupees in my bank account. So bank is promising me to give 10% of the return. So I am getting 40,000 here. Next. So here I have invested all my amount. Whatever the amount I had, I have invested. So let's look into the second opportunity what I have. That is investing in the stocks. So here, investing in the stocks or the shares, according to me, it is risky. So I decided not to invest into the shares. Instead of this, I divided my 4 lakh rupees into two equal parts, 2 lakh here, 2 lakh here, and I decided to invest 2 lakh rupees in healthcare and beauty products and 2 lakh rupees in the kitchen appliances company. So and they are promising me to give 25% of the return on my investment. So I am getting 2 lakh 25% means I am getting 50,000 here and 50,000 here. Suppose if this one area is giving loss, suppose is this healthcare products is giving loss for me, means the other area, that is kitchen appliances, can give me profit. There are probabilities, there are chances that if one investment is false, if it is giving loss, means there is probability that the other investment will give me return of 25%. So here I am getting 50,000. So let's compare here. Investing in the bank, I am getting 40,000, and investing in the kitchen appliances, even though I have got loss in one area of investment, but only investing 2 lakh rupees and getting 50,000 return is best than investing 4 lakh rupees and getting 40,000 of return. Compare this, which one is better? Obviously this one is better, because I am getting 50,000 of return by investing the 2 lakh rupees. Here I am getting 40,000 rupees return by getting by investing the 4 lakh rupees in only one area of investment, that is in the bank. So that this is what the diversification means. I have diversified my amount, 2 lakh rupees in healthcare, 2 lakh rupees in the kitchen appliances. So here, that is the diversification. Next point was the risk and the return. Risk here, investing in the stocks was risky. So I found risk in this. So I decided not to invest here. Here I am looking for the return. I am looking for the return when comparing this one and this one, where I am getting the high return. Obviously here I am getting the return. This is how I am choosing my area of investment, that is risk and return. Third we discussed was a negative correlation. So if this one is falling negatively, this is correlated, and this one is rising. So this is what negative correlation. So according to Harry Markowitz model, 3 points are there where we can choose our investment. One is diversification, another is the risk and the return, and the investment should be negatively correlated, because if one is getting us losses, means another should offset our losses by providing us the profit. Hope you understood this. Next, so the tools, what are the tools for portfolio theory? So this portfolio theory one is calculating the expected return. So there it was 25% of, they promised me 25% of return, right? So first, after investing in the after knowing about the percentage of return, I will calculate the expected return. So how to calculate that expected return? We can calculate the expected return by calculating the average, that is the mean. So sigma x divided by n, sum of all the values divided by total number of the values. Next is the variances. Variances means the differences. So it measures the spread of the risk. So how much percentage of risk is for how much percentage of the period. So second step, we will calculate the variance for the risk. Next is coefficient of correlation. Coefficient of correlation, in this we will calculate the standard deviation and the correlation coefficient, that is plus 1 and minus 1. So simply, these are the steps for calculating the problems under portfolio theory. We will discuss it in another video. Next is essence of HM model, that is Harry Markowitz model. So what are the essentials according to the HM model? So first point is, investor should have certain amount of capital. So Harry Markowitz is telling us that the investor should have the amount of capital, that is in our example we had 4 lakh rupees, right? Like that only all the persons who want to invest according to the HM model, they must have some capital. Next, he has to choose between the different investment. So if you want to follow the HM model, you must invest your capital into different investment opportunities other than investing in one area. So that is, you must have two choice between the different investment. Next point, decision depends upon if he or she wants to maximize the yield or minimize the risk. So every investor want to maximize the returns with minimum risk. So here, deciding the maximize yield and minimizing the risk is also essential, because this theory is also providing return and risk calculating tool also for the investors. So this theory is also helping us in the selection of the most efficient portfolio. For example, there are two investment opportunities. Both of them are giving 15% of return. 15% of return, and the risk of this both the investment is, this investment A is giving 20% of risk and investment B is giving 50% of risk. Now which investment you will choose? Obviously these two are giving the same return, and the first one is giving 15% of return with the lower risk, and the second one is giving 15% of risk return with the highest. So you will choose the investment A because it has lesser risk. So what this is telling us that it is helping us in choosing the most efficient investment or most efficient portfolio by calculating the risk and the return. So this Harry Markowitz model has three names. One is modern portfolio theory, another is HM, that is Harry Markowitz model, and third is mean and variance model. So don't get confused in exam if they will ask with the different names. So this is also called as modern portfolio theory, Harry Markowitz model, and also mean variance model. Next is the assumptions of the theory. So what are the assumptions given by Harry Markowitz? So according to Harry Markowitz, all the investors is aiming to avoid risk by diversifying the investment. So why he told to invest in different range of investments means to minimize and to avoid the risk. Investing in one particular investment and getting huge risk is better than investing in different range of investment and getting minimum risk is better than investing in one area of investment and getting high risk. So that is the all the investors' aim should be that they have to maximize their returns by avoiding the risk and investing in the different investments. Second assumption is all investors aim to maximize the rate of return. So of course every investor's aim is to get the maximum rate of return only. Third assumption is investment decision are based on tools of HM model. That is, what are the tools of HM model? That is calculating the mean, that is expected return, calculating the variances, and calculating the coefficient of correlation and the standard deviation for deciding the range of investments. Next, choose of investment depends on risk and return concept. That is, I told you risk and return, the percentage of risk and the percentage of return. We can compare the percentages of the risk and the return, and we can choose the efficient portfolio with the lesser returns, with the lesser risk. Next assumption is market assumed to be perfect. So perfect market means there is no taxation in the market and everyone is free to trade there. That is perfect market. Next is risk can be reduced by adding more investment. So if you want to reduce risk, you can increase your area of investment. Like first you divided your investment in two areas. So now if you want to reduce your risk, you can invest the same amount in three areas. Then if you want to reduce more risk, means you can invest in the four areas. That is, adding more and more investment means your risk exposure will be less. Investors are assumed to be having homogeneous expectation. That is, we want less risk and we want high returns. So these are the same and homogeneous expectations of all the investor. They want their money to be safe, they want accurate returns, and their investment should be less risky. These are the expectations of the investors. If you want to choose between two investments, means you have to take the one which is having the less risk, which I have already explained. So here ends the theory of modern portfolio theory. So if you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment box below. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe and share with the other students so that they can also take benefit from this lockdown period. Thank you.